Hello, I'm Daniel, and welcome to the Emunah Project. We here at the Emunah Project are continuing our series of videos with respect to inspiration, education, information, guidance, advice. And I want to touch on the subject of doubt. Doubt with respect to performing mitzvahs, commandments. Doubts with respect to halakhah, Jewish law. A lot of people find this to be a stumbling block that causes them much anxiety. How do I do this? Am I doing this properly? Should I even be doing it at all? How can I do this if it doesn't make any sense to me? I mean, this particular thing I think is ridiculous, and it doesn't make sense. I need to know what it is, and it causes them a lot of anxiety. And for this kind of person, in this kind of situations, I can recommend the words of Rabbi Chaim of Volozhin, who says, find yourself a mentor whom you can consult about any doubts that arise. This will free you from that anxiety. It would not be proper to just be stringent in every matter and not ask a competent authority, for this can have negative consequences if it is not done in an intelligent manner. This applies to kashrus, to keeping kosher. Why do we eat this and why do we not eat that? How come I can do it in this situation but I can't do it in this situation? I really, 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 really love lobster. Does God care that I'm eating a lobster? Shabbos, why am I doing this? Why am I doing that? How come I can push a piano around the house for no reason until I'm dropping dead with the fatigue, but I can't pick up a pen and write my name? All sorts of laws. And the modern way of thinking is you have to understand something before you do it. When it comes to halakha, when it comes to performing mitzvahs, oftentimes, and it has been said by our sages, belief, faith, understanding comes through doing. Don't wait until you understand before you do it, because that understanding may never come. Once you do it properly, understanding will come. If you have a doubt with respect to why we do things and why we don't do things, seek a competent authority, someone you trust, someone who knows what he's talking about, not your friends, not Rabbi Google, that you can put these questions to, a competent authority, a posek, somebody who knows you, someone who's you build a relationship with. He will put the answer in a way that you will understand, in a way that's satisfying to you, so that it doesn't sound like a lot of gobbledygook and a lot of meaningless ritual. This is meaningful ritual, and sometimes the meaning needs to be put across to you in a way that rings true. But understanding and that comes through performance. Don't wait for this mantle of knowledge and understanding to descend upon you. Don't wait for some blast of inspiration that will tell you what it all means. Do it properly. If you have a question with respect to how to do it, that's one thing. If you have a question with respect to should we be doing this at all and why the heck are we doing this, that's another question. But ask. Ask someone you trust. Ask someone that that knows the answer. Don't be overly strict with everything. And don't be overly lenient with everything. Both ways lead to improper performance. And the asking and the receiving have to be done in an intelligent manner. We're going to be doing more videos along these lines. Please come back. Please watch. Please learn. I hope you're finding them of some use. And until next time, on behalf of the Emunah Project, I'm Daniel, and thank you too much.